Welcome. I'm Eric, and in this episode, we're taking a deep dive into Steppin, which is a gamified walking, jogging app, kind of like Fitbit, but with crypto earnings. The game's in its public beta phase right now, so of course, we're going to take a look at the app, the game mechanics, and the token ecosystem. But the thing that kind of stood out to me the most about this project were actually the investors getting involved. So let's look at that really quick before getting into everything else. Don't forget to like and subscribe to keep on discovering new games. And as always, this isn't financial advice, it's just for information purposes. All right, let's get started. So this token was first brought to my attention because Binance announced that they're putting it on their launch pad. It's the GMT token, and you know, you'll be able to stake your Binance token to get an allocation and be able to purchase the GMT token. I just wanted to talk about Binance as one of the partners for this project because it's not actually listed on their website, but they're obviously involved and want to see the success of this token. So Binance partnership is great, but what actually surprised me even more was if you go to their main webpage and scroll down to their Our Backers section, you can see that the first VC fund listed is Sequoia Capital, who are basically like the OGs of the VC fund space. If you go to Wikipedia, you'll see that their past early investments that have paid off, Apple, Cisco, Google, LinkedIn, you know, just pretty much any big tech company at some point has been invested by Sequoia Capital. More recently, they've been launching these sub funds, which are crypto focused. So this is from February 17. It's five, which isn't actually that much, but they are definitely spending more effort to look into crypto and even managing and staking them to provide liquidity and participating in governance, which is kind of crazy. To kind of put it into perspective compared to other funds, I found this on Block Data. It's the top VCs investing in blockchain companies based on assets under management. And this is from September 2021, so it may have changed as of today, but Sequoia Capital is 11th on that list with $12 billion in assets under management. And you can see that some notable crypto investments so far had been FTX, Fireblocks, Chain Analysis, and Filecoin. And FTX, speaking of them, they are shown on Solana Ventures and Alameda Research. And of course, Alameda Research was founded by Sam Bankman-Fried, who is the CEO of FTX. Already right off the bat, we have Binance and FTX, like two of the top tier exchanges that are going to list this token soon. All right, so let's get into the app. This is what the homepage looks like when you log in. It takes you, you know, all you gotta do is click start to begin running right away. Let's just try that really quick. So the first thing you need is sneakers, and we'll look at that really quick. But assuming you have a sneaker and you wanna start, this is kind of what it looks like. So right now on top here, you could see that it says I'm walking. There's a green dot, which is going to give you the full credit. Since I'm not moving right now, it'll pretty shortly tell me that I'm moonwalking, and you'll see like a red dot, and that's going to, oh, right, see, it just happened. So now it's not really giving me credit for whatever I'm doing, but you know, I'm not moving anyways. So there's really no credit to be given. The other thing is it shows you your GPS signal, which is important because you want to have a good GPS signal because you actually get dinged if your GPS signal is low. So, you know, I'm inside right now, so my GPS signal is not that great. apart from that, I guess, you know, right now, right here, it shows you how many tokens you'll be earning on your walk or jog. And if you click on this map icon, it'll bring up a map view of your where you are and your current path that you've taken. And once you've stopped your run, it'll give you a summary. But of course, as I've had not gone anywhere, nothing really will happen. Looking at the rest of the app, you have your inventory, which is going to consist of mainly just sneakers and gems. Also shoe boxes, which is kind of like a loot box where a random shoe or sneaker will be generated. And on the very right is the store, which is where you're going to need to begin your journey, at least until shoe rentals come out. So you can see right now the minimum price to buy a shoe is 9.65 Solana, which is pretty expensive. That's almost like $1,000 US. So the barrier to entry until that shoe rental system comes out is pretty high. If you go up to my icon on the top left, this is your runner profile, and you'll see that there's total distance ran, the activation code, that's kind of like a referral link, I think, which I guess they don't have yet. Credit is when the rental system comes out, depending on if you fulfill your kind of obligations when you rent out shoes from somebody, that's going to impact your credit score. And, you know, you want a good credit score because a renter is more likely going to rent to somebody with a better credit score because they earn income from the renters as well. So it'll be important to fulfill your obligations if you are going to rent. And then the energy, which once that gets used up, you stop earning tokens. And I guess you can donate a portion of your earnings as well. And the last thing up here is your wallet. It's a dual token system, as we'll get into. So there's GST and GMT. The GMT is the governance token, and then you have GST, which is kind of used to upgrade the shoes. And yeah, that's really about it for the app. It's pretty simple and a pretty easy interface to understand. All right, looking at the roadmap, I talked about that rental system, which you don't need to purchase the actual shoes. And that's not coming until September of this year. So there's quite a ways to go for that. In addition, in the third quarter, you have achievement system and the quest system. Prior to that, they're going to be upgrading the wallet. And currently you need, well, because it's based on the Solana blockchain, you need Solana to purchase those NFTs. But it will soon have a multi-chain wallet upgrade and marketplace upgrade. So I'm guessing in the near future, you'll be able to use hopefully either stable coins or probably Binance token as well. And lastly, at the end of the year, there's going to be some online marathon, some SocialFi elements, which will be cool because, I mean, it'll be way funner. Just like how Fitbit, you can compete with friends. You would think that having a similar aspect in this game would be great. And community event, which I'm not quite sure what that is. All right, let's look at the GMT token and how it kind of plays into the ecosystem. The first thing to note is that don't get confused with the GMT token on CoinMarketCap. That's a whole nother ecosystem. It, you know, takes you to gmt.io. So looking at the Stepin GMT token, which is a governance token, it's going to have a $6 billion total token supply. And at the public sale price of 1 cent, that equates to a $60 million total diluted market cap. Of course, once it gets listed on exchanges to be traded, I think the price is going to be a lot higher than that. Which, if you know, if you're comparing that market cap to, for example, Star Atlas, which is just over $1 billion market cap, or Aurori, which is another big hyped token in the Solana ecosystem, which is 800 million, 60 million is a pretty low market cap. But again, it's going to shoot up once it goes on exchanges. And also, it's kind of hard to compare just because these games are so much more different than this kind of gamified walking app. Looking at the token distribution, I'm on the Binance research page, and they did a really good job writing everything up. But for the token distribution, you can see that 16% is being sold at a private sale, and 14 to the team, 2.5 to the advisors. You know, if you kind of, I've kind of tabulated it and compared it with the other games I've looked at in the past. And so 33% in total are going to the team or venture capital funds. 37% are for players or stakers, and 30% is for the ecosystem. You know, comparing the other games I've looked at, which for the most part are all in the Binance ecosystem, there's nothing that stands out one way or another. It's pretty in line with most projects. Looking at the token lockup periods, which is shown just below the allocation, there's basically a year lockup for the team and the VC funds, after which the tokens get released basically linearly. For the team, it's released linearly over 5 years, which is a lot higher, a lot longer than other projects I've seen. And for the private sale, it gets released over a period of 4 years. The long lockup periods are definitely encouraging, just because, you know, it means that the team and VC funds are invested into this game for the long run. And because the tokens are being released so slowly, it'll hopefully prevent any kind of big sell-offs from when these funds or team decides to sell their tokens. So there are two tokens in this ecosystem. There's the Green Satoshi token, GST, and then the governance token, which we've been talking about, the GMT token. So if you go to the white paper under the tokenomics section, you'll kind of get more information as to how these tokens are created and spent. For the GST token, there's an unlimited supply, and it's minted when a user moves in solo or background mode. And it gets destroyed when you mint shoes, repair shoes, level up sneakers, upgrade your gems, which is kind of just a way to boost the stats of your shoes, and unlock sockets, which allows you to place gems in your shoe, and resetting your sneaker attributes. The GMT token, which is where what I was showing about the token distribution, is the governance token, and that's burned by governance participation, taker sneaker customizations, to get max for the last parts of maxing out your sneaker level so that you can begin to earn GMTs. And I guess it's also going to be used for legendary sneaker shoe minting and to upgrade your gems to make them more efficient and to reset your sneaker attributes. So in the white paper, they talk more about the governance model, and they say 2% of the marketplace trading fee is reserved to the team to sustain its operations, and no less than 5% of the trading fee is given back to the ecosystem. So they are trying to create this circular economy where the money being spent goes back to the treasury pool, and it'll be up to the GMT stakers to decide how that gets allocated. And you can see the options are either a percentage of carbon offsetting or dividends back to stakers. And, you know, honestly, I can't see how. Most likely it's going to be a selfish taker the entire time, but hey, I could be wrong. Who knows? And I guess another thing to note for the governance is that when you lock it, depending on how long you lock it for, you will have a greater share of that voting power. So now that we know about the tokens, let's look at kind of how it works in the game and how the flow of the game is going to be. In kind of a summary, what's going to happen is you're going to purchase your NFT or rent the NFT, which are the shoes. And as you use those shoes and walk or move around, you're going to earn the GST tokens. Now, those GST tokens, which have an unlimited supply, is used to upgrade your shoes and level up your shoes so that eventually you will max out that shoe level, after which you can begin to earn GMT tokens, which is the governance. And then with those earned tokens, you can either sell them for a profit, or
you can put them into the DAO and have a say in how the and participate in the profit sharing of this game. So let's look into each of the specifics. So as you saw, sneakers are the main NFT and the main way to get into this game. And when you're looking to purchase your sneaker, it's really important to know how you're going to play the game, because that'll determine what sneaker you buy or rent. You can see here that there's four types, and each type has an optimal speed. So if you go out of that speed, you're not going to be able to earn the base return at optimal speed. So for example, if you plan on walking only, then there's really no point in buying the jogger or runner shoe, because if you don't reach those speeds, you're not going to earn that optimal return. If you plan to do everything, you know, this trainer one is the offers the widest variety, because it ranges from 1 to 20 kilometers per hour. Whereas if you get like the runner, you really can't use those shoes if you're just planning on walking. So the other important aspect of this game is the energy system. And you can't earn the in-game currency unless you have energy. And you can see on the chart here that the number of energy that you have is dependent on the number of sneakers you own and also the rarity of the sneakers. For example, if you own an uncommon sneaker, you get an extra one energy cap. And so this chart kind of explains what's going on. I don't know if you have, like, for example, if you have two sneakers, I don't know if that gives you three energy, but in general, what happens is for your max, for every energy you have, that equates to 5 minutes of movement time where you can earn. And basically a quarter of your energy gets replenished every 6 hours. So every day you'll have your full energy back. As you play the game and accumulate that GST, what you're going to want to do is start leveling up your sneakers. And the reason why you want to do that is because, again, once you get to level 30 and max out your sneaker level, then you'll be able to start earning GMT, which is the governance token, and that token that's going to theoretically keep its value and grow in value as the platform gets more popular. Leveling up your token or your shoes is also going to unlock these sockets. And what the sockets do are let you put gems in your shoes. And the gems are basically just ways to boost the attributes of your shoes so that you can earn GMT or GST tokens more effectively. So yeah, that's pretty much how that single player game works. I'm not quite sure how long it'll take to max out your sneakers so that you can begin to earn GMT. But, you know, I think the GST token it will have some kind of value as well, but my guess is you'll probably want to use that to upgrade your shoe rather than trying to sell that on the market, because the GMT token will have much more value. They are planning on introducing more game modes like we saw in the white paper, such as like the marathon mode and some other social aspects. So hopefully there'll be some rewards. Well, there will be rewards to be earned that way as well. Looking at the team, I don't have too much to say, honestly. They have the co-founders have their LinkedIn profile and Twitter here, which you can check out. The advisors, what the interesting thing is this guy, Scott, who's the VP at Adidas. So who knows, maybe some Adidas NFTs in the game. And, you know, I've already talked about the big backers. Folius Ventures is like a Chinese, it looks like it's a Chinese fund. If you go to there's not much info on their site, but if you go to their portfolio, it takes you to their Twitter page, and you can kind of see which teams I'm assuming they've invested in here. There's like Near Protocol, Project Galaxy. So that, you know, there's that. Looking at their social channels and comparing it to other games that I've looked at in the past, They only have 3,000 Telegram members, which doesn't really mean anything. Like, Telegram's not the best way to get information anyways. 63,000 Twitter followers and 40,000 Discord members. Kind of similar to all projects. You know, Discord's great for having any kind of discussion, and Twitter's the best for getting the most up-to-date news. All right, well, that's about it. To kind of summarize, pros, of course, the VC funds that are investing in this game. I think it's going to bring a lot of just exposure and just really trust to this team, which will get a lot of people interested and involved in this game. The other pro is that the app is very clean and easy to navigate and use. One thing I'm excited about doing is kind of pairing this with another game that I play, Coin Hunt World, because that involves walking around also and collecting boxes to earn Bitcoin and Ethereum. So I want to combine those two together, and I think that'll pretty much allow me to earn with both these games without really spending any extra effort. The cons is that it's a pretty high initial cost to get into this game, to purchase that first shoe. In the third quarter, they are planning on having a rental system like we talked about, but until then, it's going to cost at least as of now, $1,000 to get into this ecosystem and start earning the GST token. The other con is that until you max out that sneaker level, you're going to be earning the GST token, which is not meant to appreciate in value over time. So depending on how long it takes to max out your sneaker level and earn those governance tokens, it may or may not be worth playing the game. It just kind of depends on if you plan to do it consistently. So we don't know what that return time frame looks like. Overall, I'm super excited to try and play this game. I'm hoping the prices of the NFTs drop a little bit before I jump in, but I do want to incorporate it into my daily lifestyle as soon as possible. You know, I've made a big deal about the investors in this game. If you want to find some other games that have great investors, be sure to check out my link over here. Otherwise, I'll see you soon. Thanks for watching.